What things will you add, change, if you worked as a CEO in Bajaj for Dominar 400? Only three questions. Vibration, vibration, vibration. What's up, people? So this is going to be a Q&A video, and thanks a ton for those who have written the questions in the community tab. I owe you a lot, because I asked for 5 interesting questions in my channel and you almost gave me around 10 interesting questions. So I'm so much thankful to you guys in writing in the community tab. And if you haven't started checking out my community tab, just go and check it out. What I do is I post a picture of the motorcycle and ask you what you want to know about it. And every other motorcycles, I'll be featuring 5 of you with writing some interesting questions to me. So let's get this Q&A started on Dominar 400. So the first question is from Kapil. So what he's asking, that is, living with Dominar as a student easy, maintenance cost wise? Kapil, what I need to tell you is that the service interval for this motorcycle is around 6k kilometers, and per service it's around 2 to 2.5k. So in that calculation, consider that you are doing 1000 kilometers per month. Once in 6 months you are hitting the service interval, and say you are a student, I understand that you're getting 1000 rupees pocket money from your dad, and possibly if you save that money, Dominar just need 2.5k from that. Just 3.5k you could spend on your girlfriend. I don't know whether your girlfriend will be happy with the 3.5k, but definitely Dominar will be happy with the 2.5 which you give. Question 2. Although this machine is made for highways, but can it be used as a commuting tool? Definitely yes. Don't feel that it's a too heavy machine and all, because once you have the throttle control, you will be able to filter in the city just like anything. I have this motorcycle for around 11 days with me, and I'm filtering in the traffic like anything. The only one motorcycle which overtook me while I was filtering is the Duke 390. Otherwise, it doesn't feel so heavy and all. It's so comfortable to ride. It's not only a highway machine, it's a good city motorcycle also. Question 3. How heavy does it really feel? In spite of its huge weight, people have not felt it's as heavy as 186 kg. I think I have answered your question now. Let's go to the second person. How do you rate CBR 250R against Dominar 400 when users are mostly express highways constantly at 120 km per hour, broadly on following points? I wish my CBR is over here, so consider that to be my CBR over there. Okay, first is fuel consumption. You will get a mileage of 35 km per hour easily on a CBR 250R on a highway on that kind of a speed, and 33 to 35, so slightly CBR is staying one step ahead. Stability, I'll tell both of the motorcycles are doing good. Illumination, definitely here is the winner. Ease of use, again you have the winner here, because you could take this to off-road, highway, city, anything, but CBR is not a good off-roader. So in that case, ease of use I'll give to this motorcycle, because CBR is very bad in rough patches of road. Tractable performance, again you have the winner here. So I have to travel from Noida to Lucknow 2 to 3 times a month, approximately 500 km straight express highway. Or do you suggest investing in a Ninja 300 or an R3? Budget is not a problem, but recurring cost matters more, like fuel consumption. I need to tell that if you are considering any two-cylinder motorcycle, definitely that's a good option. You should go for it. Should go for the R3 than the Ninja. That's what my personal feel is. If you are a tourer kind of guy, R3 should be your good choice out of all these motorcycles. Next question from Jack. What about vibrations? Are they more than RE bikes, and how much mileage it delivers in city and rough riding? Vibrations are there, but not as bad as or as high as a Royal Enfield. And the mileage which I was getting is around, for touring I was getting around 33, and in city I'm actually a rough rider, so I was getting around 25 to 28 only, because I just ride it in the way it has to be. So that's the answer. Next question, Tech Praddy. What things will you add, change, if you worked as a CEO in Bajaj for Dominar 400? I mean, I think I answered this question in the community section itself. If I was a CEO of Bajaj, definitely one thing which I'm going to do is to buy myself an S1000RR, because that's my dream bike. If I have so much of money and I'm in that kind of state, I would have definitely go for a BMW S1000RR. And second thing is, CEO is not the one who decide all these things. So it's basically a tech lead or a technician lead kind of a person who decide on all these things. If I had that kind of power to do some changes to this motorcycle, then what I will be doing is to provide a taller windscreen, a bigger tank, and to provide an inherent capacity to have the panniers and make this to be a complete tourer. That's my answer. Of course, I cannot tell that I will try to reduce the vibration. There is nothing like a vibrator sitting over there to reduce the vibration. But only thing is, it's all together. You dismantle all things and try running the individual parts of this motorcycle. You won't find the vibration. It's all together when it comes with the stability of the motorcycle. So there are some amount of vibration. The bike needs to vibrate a little bit. Then only you'll understand the feel of riding and you'll understand and appreciate the value of your life when you're going too fast. Okay, next question is from Shubhendu Shil. Where did you get black alloys in 2008 Dominar 400? So yeah, this is the CS400 that has been showcased in the Auto Expo a few years back. And where did we got this black alloys instead of the golden one? What we did is, someone was buying a white Dominar, I think, and he was having the black alloys and we had the golden one. So what we thought is, we'll exchange with another Dominar. So that's how we got this. So it's a good deal. He need the golden one, we need the black one. Actually, the black one suits this motorcycle better. It's like pretty neat. This has to be the color combination and this has to be the looks that Dominar should have. Okay, Tommy has written a big questionnaire, 5 questions. So question number 1, is it okay to get Dominar as my first bike? Previously used to ride 125 and 150s. Perfectly okay, man. This is not something a ferocious motorcycle to ride like a Duke 390. It's much more civilized. You can have some amount of mistakes that you do on this motorcycle. It will forgive you in the sense, when even if you slips out of the throttle, you will be able to ride it comfortably. That's what I meant. Yes, this could be your first motorcycle if you are upgrading from a 125 or a 150cc motorcycle. Question 2 from him. Is it too heavy to handle in the city like Bangalore? No problem, man. I think I answered this question. Not at all. Is this bike economical in the sense of fuel and maintenance? Already answered. Question 4. So as I'm planning to get my first bike, my first choice was a NS200, but after seeing how great Dominar is, I have changed my mind. What's your opinion on this? What are the other options I could go for? If you had an eye on NS200 and you started looking onto this one, probably you are someone who was looking for the thrill of driving, and that too on naked motorcycles. So NS2 Dominar 400, I think you are more like a street guy. That's what I feel. So then you have an option of a Duke 250, which is also a street motorcycle, which is not as equally powerful, but powerful. You could ride it in the city, have fun. So that's one another option I'll tell. And you have Mojo, you could try that out also. What are the things I must know while getting Dominar, and suggest me a good Bajaj dealer? Bro, would it be grateful if you could answer my questions? I mean, what I understood is he's asking for a best Bajaj dealer. I don't know. In Bangalore, I know one place where the sales department is so good. Their information is there in the first comment. Go and check it out. Now, Drew have written a question. Only 3 questions, vibration, vibration, vibration. So I have 3 different answers for that. Yes, yes, yes. And you can't help with it. As I told, this is giving so much of value for money so that you'll forget the vibrations. Take it in that way. Rupesh has written, if I tell you to choose between CBR 250R and Dominar, which bike will you choose? I have answered this question in the Tourer review. So what I told is, say I have a choice to take this one or the CBR 250R, my mind will go to Dominar when I'm power hungry, and I'll go to the CBR when I want refinement. So if it was me just touring alone, this is my choice. If I have a pillion, then definitely it'll be a CBR 250R. If you want a better or an elaborated explanation for this, I have done a touring video, go and check it out. Okay, next question. Are you also among those people who'd rather be interested on a CBR 250R over RR310 and Dominar 400? P.S. I love the Dominar, but Japanese known to make motorcycles. No man. I'm not that one who look for motorcycles just for that reason. I mean, I'm not a Honda fanboy. If you have been following me for a long time, I've been given Honda many times during my reviews and stuff. So definitely no. If say I have these 3 motorcycles, the RR310, the Dominar and the CBR, I will choose these motorcycles for my purpose. say I want a tour with my Pillion, I'll go for the CBR 250R. If I want a comfortable city bike with power, I'll go for the Dominar. And if I want a track spec bike, I'll go for the RR310. That will be my choice. I have no biased feelings towards anyone, because I don't have shares in Honda or in Bajaj or in TVS. I'm not getting any profit from any of these companies, so why should I favor one of them? So that's it with this Q&A video. Once again, thanks a lot for writing to me. I will be posting such questions in my community channel. Whenever I put a photo of the motorcycle, a new motorcycle, just come and comment the things which you want to know. I'll be featuring you like this. So as always, show some love in the form of likes and comments. Sun is setting. I should leave this place now. It's so spooky. So see you in the next video. Goodbye.